what's going on? Welcome back to Mind the Wet Floor. My name is Lamont, and I would like to thank you for joining me at whatever time of the day you are watching this video. Before we move on, I would like to urge you and implore you to hit that subscribe button right on the bottom right of your screen right now. Go ahead and click it. Hit it. Hit the mouse click. Do everything. Hit the notification bell too so you're alerted when I drop my next video. I promise I'm gonna try and be more consistent from this time from now moving forward, and I shall also try to have more energy on my videos because I've been watching all my sort of past videos and stuff, and I don't really like them because I always seem like I'm so dead most of the time, mostly because I am. Without further ado, on today's video, I decided that I was going to try and style a combination of different things. So clothes that I may have worn way in the past that I still have, that hopefully still fit with more modern styling. So I basically wrote down a list of a bunch of random items that I'd never wear together. I don't know how many of them I wrote down, but hopefully it's an even number. And I put them in this hat, this fedora, this tiny fedora, as you can see. There's some papers in there. And yeah, basically fold them up. I'm gonna shake it up and pick two items that I'm going to style. So regardless of what the two items are, it's gonna be items in different colors too, so it's not very easy for me to do it. Obviously, because if, let's say I just picked, if I wrote down black pants, black shirt, or black pants, white shirt, it's too easy. Although there's some of that in there, I try to mix it up, keep it exciting, and hopefully we'll be able to find some stuff. I wanted to see if maybe this would give me some new inspiration as to outfits in the future, and also just see what would work that I just, from my own taste and my own mind, wouldn't think would work together. I don't mean to be talking so much at the beginning of all these videos, but without further ado, let's get straight into it. I'm gonna shake this up, then I'm gonna pick, two items, see which one I come up with, and then I'll insert, obviously, a video of me wearing the two. So the first item is, drum roll, a faux fur jacket. I'm gonna put that to the screen, so I don't even know if it's gonna be able to pick that up, but that says you can't see it. I don't know how close I need to get for it to like not focus on me. Okay, that was useless, but I can assure you that says faux fur jacket. That's item number one that I have to style. If I'm gonna shake it up again, hopefully it's gonna give me something. This is like a brown faux fur jacket, and a white formal shirt. White formal shirt, it's gonna be relatively easy. So I've got first item, faux fur jacket, white formal shirt. We've got a relatively easy fit to start this whole thing off. Just a red, I think is the color. The sort of reddish brown, brick red, if you will, faux fur jacket that I bought about 2 years ago off of the ASOS marketplace. And right underneath it, we have the white formal shirt, which I believe I got from Zara. Quite a long time ago now. I think I've had it for about 5 years. Just a closer look at the detailing. It has these sort of gunmetal buttons coming down the front. And yeah, that's about it for the outfit. Nothing too crazy. Coming in at outfit number two. I hope this one's a bit more exciting than the first one, because I was really hoping, you know, to get some exciting things out of this. Coming in next, we have a pink blazer. Pink blazer with a striped satin shirt. This is gonna be a bit more interesting. Man over here looking like Pablo Escobar, like I belong in one of the series or the episodes of Narcos. We have a pink double breast fit blazer, checkered pink to be precise, that I don't remember where I bought it, but I've had it for about 2 years now. And underneath it, we have a striped satin shirt from Zara, which I picked up a couple of years ago. Just has these beautiful different colors coming down. Oh! Next up, we have checkered coat. Oh, this is a long overcoat. Checkered coat. Again, I don't know why I'm showing this to the camera, because I'm pretty sure you won't be able to see it. Yeah, we have a checkered coat with a cardigan. Okay. Not too bad. Again, not a particularly difficult thing to do.
Pretty dull look, in my opinion. Not too much happening. It's just two very monochrome and solid colors. The checkered coat coming over it, and a cardigan, which I've worn in one of the previous episodes of Mind the Wet Floor. Styled this with a bucket hat. Again, not too much color going on. Also did an alternative to that look, which involves this hat, which I don't know what it's called, but yeah, that's the look.
Come on, give me something interesting, give me something interesting. Pink trousers with orange beanie. Okay, this is gonna be a lot of color blocking. Might as well just go like full fledged out colors with this one and go all out, go crazy with the colors.
You know how they say men lie unprovoked? Well, I just lied because I definitely didn't go for color blocking. Instead, I went for this very plain black t-shirt, just a solid black t-shirt, along with these wide leg, sure you can't see that they're wide leg, but I assure you they're wide leg sort of pinstripe trousers, if you will. And we have an orange beanie as the hat. You know, I always wear hats. I've accessorized that with this bag, this sort of canvas bag that I picked up at a bookstore a couple of years ago. I use it for everyday errands. Says more issues than Vogue in the front, which could possibly be true.
Come on, I don't even know what more's remaining. This, gonna shank it. Try not to spill the stuff that's in there. Ba 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 ba. Coated denim trousers. Ooh, these are my favorites right now. They're coated in like this plastic leather, so they kind of look like leather trousers, but they're really not. They're just denim trousers with some coating on them. It's too hot for thingy. With a yellow beanie. Oh, that's easy. That's boring. I'm not gonna do that one. I'm gonna pick something else. So I'm gonna fold that back in there. I want it to be with something a bit more exciting. Hopefully I don't pick up the same thing again. If it comes up again, then I guess I'm gonna have to do it. But if not, I'd rather have something a bit more exciting. So we have the coated denim trousers with... still boring. Steel gray scarf. Don't really want to do that either. Trying to make this exciting. I thought this would be a bit more exciting. Steel gray scarf. Nope. Pick a different one. Come on. I feel like this is probably cheating. With the red skinny jeans? Could I? I'll do it, but I'll pick two more items to make like separate outfits with them too. So I'll do both of them together somehow, and then I'll do two more just because I'm interested in seeing how I'd combine the two, which is, I suppose, just I'd layer it more often than not. That'd just be the most obvious choice, but we'll see. I'm gonna put those together for now. Coated denim trousers and red skinny jeans. Then I'm gonna pick two more things, so I do two separate outfits with them. We've got a pink hoodie. Obviously you're gonna wear the Well Is Dry hoodie with this one. And the wild card. Now the wild card is a, what are they called? Waistcoats. Yes, the wild card is a waistcoat that I wore at the first wedding I was ever a groomsman in when I was like 9 years old. I don't know if it still fit, but it would probably because I was really big as a kid. So a lot of my clothes and also fashion back then was a lot wider. Everything was about large fitting clothing. So it might fit. I just saw it in my wardrobe the other day. I haven't tried it on. So if it doesn't fit, then I apologize. But if it does fit, then it'll make for an interesting outfit. Just to make it clear, we're gonna have the coated denim trousers with the red skinny jeans. Then we're gonna do two separate outfits with either the pink hoodie and the wild card, which is the waistcoat. Is that, yeah, I said that right, right? Yeah, the waistcoat. For some reason, that sounds like I'm saying something wrong. But yeah, I'll be the waistcoat.
And this is the first outfit. Again, if you're under 18, you might want to cover your eyes because this is NSFW. Just want to state that I'd never wear this outfit like this for obvious reasons. There's just too many colors than I personally would like to wear. This is a more realistic representation of how I'd wear this outfit, even though I'd probably not wear skinny jeans in 2020. I have this white Calvin Klein overshirt, which I picked up at the Calvin Klein store a couple of months ago. I know, I probably need to iron, well, not even probably, I definitely need to iron it. So that's outfit number one. Coming in at number two, we have the waistcoat, ever so shiny, with the coated denim trousers. This, I think I've had it since I was like 10 years old, like I already stated. I'd probably actually wear this today if I could get it to button, but again, your man's a bit thick, so I don't think it will fit. Right, next on the list, we have yellow beanie with the corduroy trousers, which also happen to be yellow, so I'll do that. I think I have an idea for that. Easy. I look like I belong on some sort of camping trip with this fit. I probably just wear this casual everyday look, something simple, and I've got a bit of errands to run, some meetings perhaps, corduroy trousers, everything's wide leg that you've been seeing. I've accessorized it with this bag, just my regular backpack in this sort of pebble grain leather with brown leather straps that I really like. I think I got it from Debenhams, if I'm not mistaken, and the yellow beanie. Steel gray scarf. So the steel gray version of the scarf that I'm wearing on my head right now. Steel gray scarf. Shop the well is dry, by the way, before I move on. If you haven't already, go click on the bio. And a tie-dye shirt. It's a tie-dye overshirt. So yeah, cool. Steel gray scarf, tie-dye shirt. Got this tie-dye shirt in gray and sort of black, I suppose would be the tie-dye color. I don't really know. I'm guessing they dyed the black over the gray or opposite. I don't know. I don't really know how tie-dyeing works, which is a bad thing to say. And of course, the well is dry steel gray hoodie over the head. This is another way in which I'd wear it around my neck, which is usually how I wear these scarves. Fisherman vest. Haven't decided which one of my fisherman vests I'm gonna wear, but depending on what the next, this is again cheating, depending on what the next item is, then I'll pick which color. I have two colors that I'm thinking of, which is military green and black, so we'll see. Come on, I need something exciting. None of these are like fire. They're just, but it's fine. It's black trousers, so I can literally do either one of them. I'll do the green one. Fisherman vest, black trousers.
Relatively easy fit, all black. We've got the fisherman vest, if you will, from Arkit, which I bought again a couple of years ago. Has multiple pockets, very utilitarian, if that's the correct phrase. Yeah, and I really like this vest. I wear it as much as I can because it's just very user-friendly and very useful. And on the pants, I've got these pants that I picked up from All Saints, of course, wide leg pleated.
Right, what we got? We're reaching the end now. We have three more papers in here. We have a kimono, my favorite item between 2014 and 2016. I wore it all the time, still probably wear it every day if I could. We have a kimono with a kimono with white satin trousers. This is a pair of trousers that I'm very sure I own, but I haven't worn in a year, and your boy's gotten a bit thick, so I don't really know if the gains are gonna allow me to fit into those trousers, but hopefully they do, because I've really been looking forward to this outfit. So prayers up and fingers crossed that I'm able to fit in these trousers and make this outfit work.
This is yet another shameless plug. This is the Well is Dry kimono in black with the hand-drawn sketch on the back by my guy Kanono. Shout out to him. I've paired this with a black beanie and an all-white ensemble on the inside. You've got the satin trousers at the bottom, and if you know me, you know I'm always carrying a bag of some kind. This is a bag from Zara in leather or I think this one might actually be leather. But yeah, got it a couple of years ago. It's actually wearing down now, so I'm probably in need of a new one. If you know where I can find one, hit me up. That's the fit.
And finally, we have pink sneakers. Well, if this is the pink sneakers, I think I know what the last item is, because there's only one more paper remaining. So this is the pink sneakers. I think I know what the next item is, but I decided to switch it up because the initial option I had was too easy. Yep,
I had a white overshirt initially, which is different from a formal shirt, so it's more, it's kind of like in between a jacket and a shirt. But I'm gonna change that, and I'm gonna do a white lab coat if I still own mine. This is a lab coat that I had since secondary school from like chemistry and biology and all that stuff. So I'm gonna try and style that, and we'll see how it goes.
I'm actually quite surprised this lab coat still fit me, given that I haven't worn it since like 2011. But yeah, it still fits. I'm wearing an Andy Warhol t-shirt, which I picked up from Uniqlo, the same t-shirt that I'm wearing in, well, the other part of this video. I really like this t-shirt. I probably get more. So yeah, check out the Uniqlo collection if you want more t-shirts like this. Just plain white lab coat. Got the sneakers on the bottom. These are Reeboks, which I picked up a couple of months ago. If you've seen my previous videos or some of my pictures, I might be wearing them in them. I really, really like these shoes. They're super comfortable. An alternative to this would be my reflective boots, which I wear only on special occasions, mostly because I don't want to crease them. They're very near and dear to me. I've got vintage trousers on the bottom, which is how I'd wear this entire look.
We are officially done. There's nothing more remaining in the hat, as you can see. I'll probably just wear that on my head for now. I haven't worn this for years. Thank you so much for watching this video. This has been Mind the Wet Floor with Lamont. Please make sure to hit the subscribe button. Leave a comment down below of what your favorite outfits that I picked was. If you'd like to see more of these kinds of videos, hopefully in the future I can do more of those for you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care. Peace. I don't know why I did that in the opposite. Take care. Peace.